यस माय सेल्फ श्रद्धा कटोच एंड ड्यू टू कोरोना ऑल आर सिटिंग एट होम सो आई जस्ट थॉट टू स्टार्ट विद द क्लासेस ऑनलाइन इटसेल्फ सो दैट आई विल ऑल्सो बी कनेक्टेड विद द स्टूडेंट्स सो टूडे आई विल गो थ्रू द टॉपिक for class 9 ICSE board that is cell it might be of your interest or your syllabus but if you are interested then do listen to this so that if you gain some knowledge it will be good for you so I will go through the topic cell what is a cell sabse pehle jab hum cell padhte hain तो हमारे दिमाग में ऑलवेज इट इज देयर दैट व्हाट इज अ सेल कहाँ है बॉडी में सेल स्किन के ऊपर सेल कहाँ है सो वी कैन से वी ऑल हैव सीन इन फैक्ट दैट द स्मॉलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स स्पेशली द स्मॉलर वंस एमीबा पैरामीशियम दीज ऑल आर माइन्यूट and microscopic structures so these microscopic structures a microscope it means minute cannot be seen from the naked eye so they all are a single cell structures they have a single nucleus ab different organelles ki baat karenge so we can say that cells are where they are cells cells are actually the building blocks ab blocks kaise samjhe hum as whenever the house is built it is built on the bricks so what are these bricks are the building blocks so puri building jo banegi ab wo iske upar banegi to same as cell ह्यूमन का जायगोट और वी कैन से अ सिंगल सेल दैट इज जायगोट थ्रू विच डिफरेंट सेल्स गेट डी डिफरेंशिएटेड री डिफरेंशिएटेड एंड ग्रो एंड फॉर्म अ फुल ह्यूमन बीइंग सो वी विल जस्ट गो थ्रू द थियरी पार्ट फ्रॉम ए बुक ऑल्सो सो दैट यू ऑल्सो गेट कनेक्टेड विद द टॉपिक वट इज रिटन इन द सेल इज वॉट इज अ सेल So there is a huge range of living organisms from the microscopic amoeba to the large animal that is the blue whale jo hamare universe mein earth mein sabse bada then going with the first definition of cell ye aapne pehle bhi padha hai that cell is a fundamental structural and functional unit of life ab isko apan yahi discuss kar lete hain ki structural aur functional ka part kya matlab hai structure ka matlab means from starting with the organs hamare skin ke brain ke muscles ke they are all composed of 100 of such cells yes so it means that all have different structures for example hum skin ki baat kar rahe hain they are cuboidal cells we have studied this before also then if we talk about the nerve cells they are long spindle shaped cells yes then if we talk about the brain cells they also have a particular shape how they are built then so we say that they are the fundamental in their structure and function a functional role kya hai every cell is performing its function because every cell has its own organelles into it and it is working according to that it means that nerve cell is according to that brain cell apna kaam kar raha hai every cell is fundamentally structurally and fundamental independent and play a role in the unit of life. So every cell has its own life. ये देखो life. यहां से एक और चीज आई that they get older, weaker, and some are getting replaced. अब सबसे अच्छा एग्जाम्पल कैसा है replaced का, skin cells होते हैं replaced. Then RBCs, they get replaced. Skin cell तो every time it get worn out, we get hurt, worn out हो जाता है, then only we get. Weaker might be if your immunity is low, WC, BC are fighting for it, they are dying. But RBC get replaced by the particular days, that is 120 days. This always keep in mind. So RBC, that is the red blood cells, for instance, die after about 120 days. So here we can go through this chapter, this page of your book. Cells are so microscopic that they cannot be seen with the naked eye. So their natural existence jab bhi hua hoga, or men would have detected it, they would have first detected what? Microscope to see them. So the first microscope was formed by the ground lenses, who ground the lenses and made microscope observation as a hobby. That was Antony van Leeuwenhoek. He was a Dutch scientist and he first discovered or constructed, we can say simply, a microscope. And all his microscope consisted of a single biconvex lens. Single biconvex lens, which was called as simple microscope. Today we use it in our labs also. Aisa nahi hai, we don't use it. We use it for seeing the smaller root cells. Just uski anatomical study karni hai to. Then later on, more discovery was going on. Robert Hooke, who actually worked to discover the cell also. He was the first one who coined the term cell, or we can say from cellula. He was the first one who saw the cell under the microscope in the cork of Quercus tuber. It should be in a small form. A species of a plant, and reported in his book that is named as Micrographia. ये टॉपिक हमेशा डिस्कस होता है. दे माइट बी साइंस का कोई आपके क्विज हो या जीके हो, रॉबर्ट हुक बहुत डिस्कस होता है. एंड लेटर ऑन ही आल्सो डिस्कवर्ड और यूज्ड द डबल लेंसेज एंड फॉर्म्ड द माइक्रोस्कोप दैट वाज कॉल्ड एज द कंपाउंड माइक्रोस्कोप. तो इन हिज नेम मेनी इन्वेंशंस इज Now, what is written there? I'll just go through your page number 7. Robert Hooke, an English scientist, developed a microscope by using the two lenses. So, that two lenses is then later on formed the compound microscope. Ab dekhti baat hai, if they are using the two lenses, it means that its magnifying power would have increased. Nowadays what we use, उसने क्या use किया था, he used oil flame and a mirror to reflect or see the light and see the image. And later, nowadays, we use electron microscope. Now, here what we use, here the source beam of electrons is used, which are bent by, वो bent क्या कैसे हो रहे थे mirror से, ये यहाँ पे bent हो रहे, they were bent by the magnets. I'll just discuss the few topics which are actually discussed under this topic. Okay. Then comes the cell theory. This was all about this cell general introduction. Now coming to the cell theory, the major part hai iska. What is a cell theory? First, who gave it? Cell theory was given by in 1838 by Malthus, Sheldon, who was a botanist or a German botanist. Who announced that every plant is made up of large number of cells. Then later on, Schwann, a German zoologist, who then a zoologist, so it means that he would have studied in animals, but then he concluded the cell or the theory about the cells in both the animals and plants. And said that, and concluded, not said, animals and plants are composed of cells. So, and it served as the units of structure and function. So it was later on called as the cell theory, that all cells are, first topic, three major topics, cell theory ke par baat kare agar, three major topics of this cell, that all the cells are developed from the pre-existing cells, or all cells arise from pre-existing cells. And this pre-existing cell was also shared by, this topic we can say, it was also shared by Rudolf Virchow. So here in this topic, we can say that he also contributed little in the cell theory. Then the second point of cell theory. First, hamara ye tha. Second point of the cell theory was all living organisms are composed of cells and their products. So the third is that cell is the structural and functional unit of life. And here we can conclude that that these three major points, abhi cell theory hai na, so these three major points will always be there in all the living organisms. But exception was the exception here. We can add here only. I'll add here only so that the topic is ended over here only. That exception was the virus. As viruses have no protoplasm. But have only RNA or DNA. Then later on, or be exceptions I as for sense, blue-green algae, blue-green and bacteria that lagged nucleus. Certain algae were also multinucleated. Certain algae were multinucleated. So हम बोल सकते हैं कि exceptions out of cell theory इनके ऊपर नहीं लागू होता है. Then later Rudolf Virchow जो हमने first discuss किया था, first to explain that cells divide and new cells are formed from the pre-existing data. Third, first point हमने discuss किया इसमें, that it arises from the pre-existing cells. It was by the Rudolf Virchow, the contribution of this Rudolf Virchow. Now adding to the cell theory that all cells are fundamentally similar in chemical composition and the metabolic activities. उसके structural and functional role से, this one, structural and functional role से, meaning ये है कि they are similar in their chemical composition and metabolic activities. अब chemical composition, they might be having proteins, they need carbohydrates, like हमने messenger में पढ़ा होगा that proteins are the messengers. So every cell has its own chemical composition, or they are similar in their chemical compositions and the metabolic activities. And one more thing, I just need to add this, that Rudolf Virchow, Rudolf Virchow, in his own language, added to the cell theory, that is ominous cellula, E cellula. ये सेलुला ही सेलुला ये हमेशा इसी वर्जन में, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू एनी काइंड ऑफ क्विज आल्सो दे आस्क हू सेड दिस एंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस, इट मींस दैट ऑल द सेल्स फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम द प्री एग्जिस्टिंग सेल्स. Then the other part, the function of an organism is the outcome of activities and interactions of the cells. Whenever, if the cell is there, it will interact with the other cell. It will then functionally interact with the other cells. Just in our brain, mein every signal has been given by what? The series of these signals by these different cells. Nerve cells ho gaya, ya koi bhi hum bole, motor nerves. So is this cell which are interacting with the other cells. Now coming to the topic, what does this cell theory mean actually? Again coming to the same topic, what does cell theory mean? Cell theory means that structural unit agar wo bola gaya hai, that every part of the body jo examine hua hai, it shows its own cellular structure. If it is talking about the function unit, then every cell is working. As for sense, muscle cell is working, nerve cell is working its own, leaf का जो पोर्शन है वो अपना फंक्शन कर रहा है, उसमें जो स्टोमेटा है दैट इज वर्किंग अकॉर्डिंग टू इट, जाइलम सेल्स हैं वो पुल के लिए काम कर रहा है. सो व्हाट इज देयर, दैट सेल इज प्लेइंग इट्स फंक्शनल रोल एज वेल एज स्ट्रक्चरल रोल. देन थर्ड इज द सेल डाई एंड गेट रिप्लेस्ड. सो एवरी टाइम दीज सेल्स कंटिन्यूसली डाई एंड आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय द न्यू वंस. Like we all know, in division of the cells, in younger cells will be faster, or we can say younger cells, or the young ones. Sorry, not the younger cells, but the young ones have more power of division. The cells present in them, they have more power to develop or divide, as for sense in adults. So is the same thing here. Formation of the cells from the pre-existing is a never-ending chain. Every time when we get hurt at that particular point, the cells or the skin get eroded, but later on, jitna bhi after some time it gets worn out, the cell gets divided, and then the whole of that particular wound is, we cannot find it where is the wound, but we can find out that the new skin is there. So what is there? The cell get divided, that cells of the skin getting divided and new skin has taken place. And all life start as a single cell. All the life, we all know, seed se plant banta hai, zygote se animal banta hai. So what is there? Embryo se form hoga, single cell. Starting from the single cell in the ovary of the flower and the pair. You have studied previously also, the fertilization process hai in the ovary. So all cell arises from the single cell. So, and we all know they are all in many numbers. Like how numerous are the cells? Larger an organism, greater the number of cells in the body. Dono opposite form mein. Single cell honge, many of the small plant and animals are made up of just one single cells. That we have discussed this before only. सिंगल सेल के स्ट्रक्चर्स के एनिमल्स के अगर आपको पता हो सिंगल सेल स्ट्रक्चर, वी कैन से बैक्टीरिया, यीस्ट, एमीबा, सिंगल न्यूक्लियस, सिंगल माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया प्रेजेंट होगा, अ फ्यू सेल्ड वंस, very small plant and animal, there are very relatively few cells are present, and they are spirogyra, Wallbox, yeah, Wallbox ka structures aapko aise aise, amoeba ka structure is aise, aur isme iske khud ke nucleus honge, present honge, but it is single cell. यहाँ पे अब कहीं कहीं के बहुत सारे न्यूक्लियस भी प्रेजेंट है, तो ये क्या हो गए, फ्यू सेल्स मोर, ठीक है. देन मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड, और वी कैन से मल्टी सेल, मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड वर्ड अलग है, मल्टी सेल्ड स्ट्रक्चर. मल्टी सेल्ड में कहाँ सबसे बड़ा एग्जांपल है, प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. सो हियर वी कम टू the topic, end of it, the topic conclusion, that what is a cell, what does a cell theory mean, how we have discovered or come through the cell with the help of the simple and compound microscope. Now coming to the structures of cell, how small are they and what is actually the role cell kya hua? सेल की एफिशिएंसी उसके वॉल्यूम और उसके सरफेस एरिया पे डिपेंड करता है. एंड अगेन दिस इज द टॉपिक व्हिच यू शुड बी केप्ट इन कीप इन योर माइंड. द सेल्स आर वेरी स्मॉल एंड आर सीन ओनली विद द माइक्रोस्कोप्स. स्मॉलेस्ट सेल्स आर द बैक्टीरिया एंड आरबीसीज इन द ह्यूमन बीइंग. एक जनरल टॉपिक है वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द स्मेल स्मॉलेस्ट बैक्टीरिया में The size is 0.3 to 5 माइक्रोमीटर. और ह्यूमन बींग्स में अपन आरबीसी की बात कर रहे हैं, देर अबाउट 7 माइक्रोमीटर अबाउट अप्रोक्स. देन लॉन्गेस्ट वन ऑल्सो वी नो नर्व सेल्स. इमेजिन अ सेल और वी कैन से द सेल विच इज मूविंग फ्रॉम, या पूरा उसका जो स्ट्रक्चर है फॉर्मिंग फ्रॉम द टो रनिंग टू द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इन टू द ब्रेन, कितना लॉन्ग है. कुछ भी पिंच करेगा द मशीनरी इज गोइंग गिविंग द सिग्नल टू द ब्रेन पार्ट. सो दैट इज द लॉन्गेस्ट सेल्स. देन बात करें लार्जेस्ट की. वेयर इज लार्जेस्ट? लार्जेस्ट सेल वी ऑल नो एग सेल. किसका? बर्ड का. That is the ostrich. And before the development, or the largest single cell of the living world today. So, we can say the smallness of the cell is to the greater its efficiency. Smaller cell होगा, it means ऐसा नहीं है कि उसमें efficiency नहीं होगी. Smaller cell, a greater efficiency. Cell generally remains small in size, and this is two main reasons for that. Different regions of a cell can communicate with each other rapidly for the cell to function effectively. Cells have a larger surface area is to volume ratio. Larger surface area, dekho. Larger surface area is to volume ratio. बहुत ज्यादा सरफेस एरिया होगा उसका वॉल्यूम छोटा. वॉल्यूम अगर ज्यादा हो तो सरफेस एरिया कम है. इट मींस उसकी एफिशिएंसी जो है उसके हम इस रेशियो को फॉर डिफरेंट डिफ्यूजन ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस इन एंड आउट ऑफ द सेल्स. कैसे करेंगे? हाउ वी फाइंड इट आउट दैट उसकी एफिशिएंसी? बायोलॉजिकल जो सिग्निफिकेंस है, द सेल्स हैव अ लार्जर सरफेस एरिया इज टू वॉल्यूम रेशियो फॉर ग्रेटर डिफ्यूजन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस इन एंड out. Biological significance, volume determines its amount. Volume kya karega? Volume determines the amount of chemical activity of cells. Uski kya chemical activity of hogi? While the surface area kya determine karega? Surface area determines the amount of absorption. जो amount of absorption by the cell surface, या बोल सकते हैं release of waste. Example हम intestine में हमने पढ़ा है, microvilli is there. वॉल्यूम कैसा भी हो उसने क्या किया, अपने आप को इंटरडिजिटेट किया. इंटरडिजिटेट मींस इंक्रीजिंग द उसका सरफेस एरिया ऑफ एब्जॉर्प्शन. सो टिल हियर वी कंक्लूडेड अबाउट द सेल, इट्स फंक्शन, इट्स एफिशिएंसी, एंड नाउ लेटर ऑन इन द नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कवर अबाउट द सेल शेप्स and the types or the structure of a cell. So till here, if you have understood or some of the things which you have not understood, you can just write or comment there and share it. Thank you.